I broke the thing.
Did you?
I accidentally went to camera. Oops. We're sleeping. We're napping. Nah, just kidding. Game number two here in this best of three. The Mongols up against Fnatic. Game number one went the way of Fnatic. Kind of unexpected, though. The Mongols really put up a great fight and managed to hold out for like 30 minutes while Fnatic were definitely on the ropes and on the back foot. But game number two, a different beast. At least with the Lone Druid being first phase banned by the Malaysians, but still going for the first pick, Vengeful Spirit.
Just thinks this hero sort of fits their wheelhouse. And Fnatic must feel so confident. They can just do whatever they want and win. At this point, they're undisputed at this rate. They're really feeling it right now.
They know what they want.
Yeah, they're running net as their support, or their support player as their carry. You got this new player, and they're still winning everything. If anything, they look even better. It doesn't feel like
they lost anything with Mushi being sick.
Yeah.
I mean, 343 has been a great stand-in.
He really has been. This guy's rotations and the way that he drafts has really helped this team out a lot, actually.
10 seconds remaining.
Like, Fnatic got 2-0'd by MVP, and then all of a sudden, you know, they're just like 5-0'ing them.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Knocked him out of Epicenter. Oh, Invoke Avenge again. This time, though, the Mongols get their hands on the Outworld Devourer. This was something we saw Retribution really utilize quite well the other day up against First Departure. Don't think he died once. Remaining. Like, his laning prowess is pretty damn good. And I'm just going to reiterate, but these guys, at least Cap, myself, and Toby, we met them in Azerbaijan a year...
I was not there.
Over a year and a half ago? It was November 2014. Just before I joined JD. Radiant we went there for IESF. There's the Mongolian team, Romanian team, Chinese team, which is basically newbie. But we talked to the Mongols, and they basically said, we can't play in Europe because ping is like, you know, 250, 300. We can't play in China because ping is like 300 and also it's relatively difficult for them there. So Southeast Asia, they get like 230 ping, something like that, to Singapore servers.
So no matter what, they're at a disadvantage, and they're still pretty good.
Yeah. Not just pretty good, but, you know, the difference between them and First Departure the other day, First Departure playing from Singapore and having six ping, and them having 250, and they just, like, 2-0 crushed them. Oh, that's good stuff. Good stuff. Well, Oracle banned out by Fnatic. The Mongols take out the Darkseer this time around. Still difficult to say where they're going to be heading, though. I mean, Nature's Prophet didn't even get touched in the last game, did it?
No. But they were Darkseer. I can forgive that. Plus, they already had a lot of heroes taken out. Like, they took the Darkseer early, which I'm okay with. They took it third. And they picked up the Earth Spirit, so they thought they could get a lot more. Like, Earth Spirit plus Darkseer is a pretty strong combo. You Ion Shell the Earth Spirit, then he just does fun Earth Spirit things. It's really hard to stop.
Witch Doctor. This, of course, still leaves Chen in the pool. And the Mongols probably have that on their mind after DJ's performance in game number one, pretty reasonable. And there we go, Chen ban and the instant Doom pickup from the Mongols Fnatic's as well. Fnatic had the Batrider in mind the whole time. Batrider against both Earth Spirit and OD. You've got like Astral, you've got Kick and Grip. Not going to be the easiest time actually picking out a target, but laning stage should be okay for Ohio, I think.
What makes this a good pick too is you know the playstyle of the Earth Spirit. You know he's gonna run around a lot, and Batrider does really well against weak dual lanes just because you can trade hits with both supports. You can pull out the side wave, do that camp, if they're not careful. Like, there's a lot of options with this hero in my opinion.
Well, the Mongols. Doom plus Earth Spirit, not the best support duo. Does this push Doom into like off lane or safe lane core role?
I think it's just the 4 position. Although I don't like it as a 4. It's weird, actually.
And then you have a 5 Earth Spirit roaming around as well.
I mean, maybe you just pick really self-sufficient lanes. Not sure, actually. That is a little bit weird. I think you just pick self-sufficient lanes and you're okay anyways.
Just have a lot of solo laners.
Yeah. It's not an ideal solution, but it's the best you're going to get.
Oh, OD, of course, can be safe lane or mid. More likely than not going to be that mid laner, though. Deal with the Forge Spritz with your Arcane Orb. And Disruptor is going to be the pick, so it is going to be a core Doom.
I've not seen this in a really long time.
I saw it the other day, and... Oh, it was MVP Phoenix that did it, I'm sure. They ran like a one-roll Doom for Mental Protector. And it didn't do well. That was a series they lost like 3-0.
Call him MP, man. He's done with Mental Protector.
10 seconds remaining. Mana points.
Doesn't like it.
Oh, does he not?
I don't think so.
Solo ranked warrior.
We all call him MP now.
It's just easier as well.
It's been a while, too, since he used that name. That was back Radiant in the Bird Gang days.
A long while ago. But yeah, he had to like rush BKB because Doom, outside of his ultimate, sure, he farms decently well with Devour, but actual scaling isn't that great from the hero.
Hero's like weird. Feels really good. It's really good against Invoker, but just kind of doesn't do a whole lot reserve time. If you're behind.
I wonder if he goes towards the offlane. Like, Scorched Earth was always that ability that just keeps you sustained and, you know, tips ganks in your favor if you do get jumped on by a stun. Maybe they could play aggressively with Doom plus Earth Spirit dual lane as well. That could be an option. Fanatics turn to ban. Fnatic go back with the Spectre. They've loved so much recently. Net will be happy to be over on that hero rather than the Sven, I'm sure. They're a lot more practiced on it.
A hero that does not care if he gets doomed. Especially if he gets his ultimate off. 10 seconds remaining.
Well, fifth pick out from the Mongols. I've actually just been told by the admin that they've currently got 50 ping to these servers.
Nice.
So I don't know if since we last talked to them they've improved their internet connections or if they've moved closer or something like that, but I was wrong.
Good for them.
Yeah. Maybe that's been the upswing for them. Better ping, easier time against some of these teams. The Mongols, one roll Doom. Or the offlaner. No, it still feels like they're lacking something to deal with the Spectre, a bit of physical damage, and Phantom Lancer will more likely than not provide you that. We've got Disruptor and Earth Spirit to try and control these lanes. Phantom Lancer, not the easiest to gank. Do you want to put the PL mid and OD safe lane, though?
Yeah. PL's really good against...
Invoker.
Invoker mid.
Okay. And then Fnatic just need their final support for Chrissy. No Bounty, no Enchantress, no Chen. Three of his heroes will be banned out. There's no Enigma. Four of his heroes have been banned out. It's a rough spot for his drafter, honestly, when like all of Chrissy's heroes have been removed. Reserve time. What's even left for commonly picked heroes? Like Lion, potentially? Bane doesn't really set up for too much here for him.
Trying to think right now.
There's no Chen or Beastmaster for a Winter Wyvern to be important.
Sure, we're missing something.
I don't know. I'm looking at a hero list and it's honestly it's a bit difficult. Like Silencer was once a popular four roll hero, but he's not popular at all anymore anyway.
Sure, the hero is Earthshaker.
Rubick maybe? Rubick Venge, kind of roaming duo a little bit. Can control both mid and safe lane.
Sure, the hero is Earthshaker.
Okay, I'll defer to you. It's Nightstalker. It's a melee. It's a melee support. You were close.
They needed something. You need something that deals damage.
Hmm.
The vision game, though. Oh, it was Cap that pointed it out today. Batrider plus NS. Really good combo.
Oh, yeah. Ags into Blink Lasso.
I'm going to pick that later tonight.
Giving away your strats already.
Yeah.
You playing JDL or just scrimming?
Just scrimming. Old Vegetable Esports Club. Good times.
Veggies!
The first 2 days, we won like every scrim. Lately... Oh.
Downhill?
Rough times, rough times.
Dear. Maybe it's time to bring in Charlie.
Yeah, Charlie is our seventh. Good meme.
Who's the other? Is it Fogged?
Yeah, it's Fogged.
Okay.
Fogged is too good for this team.
It's kind of sad that he didn't have a place to go.
Yeah, things happened. He got screwed over. Maybe that's the wrong word. Because nobody tried to scrimmage. It's just one of those situations. It the roster happened. Lock, it hurts. You have to make, like, decisive decisions, like, last second.
It's like, kind of left by the wayside.
Yeah, exactly. Kind of sucks. Everyone's scrambling, like, to find something as soon as possible. Somebody's going to get kind of tossed.
That's the thing, like, subs don't really do anything on these big teams either. Yeah,
subs are... I don't think a sub has been useful yet.
No.
Although, the only time it could have been was for IG when their visa issue hit.
Mm.
But you're never... Hopefully, you're never going to have to use your sub.
Because that's the thing. Subs don't get invited to majors and stuff. It's just the five
you
primary.
I think you get to choose who you bring to the major, obviously. Because if you have two coaches, for example, you prefer that over your sub, right?
Yeah.
Unless your sub happens to be your coach. But that's rarely the case. Prepare your sub's just... Battle. In my experience, it's just like sometimes your friend or some guy that you just kind of use as a shout-out thing or... I don't think you plan on using your sub if you can help it.
Already. Very quick observer wards out from Fnatic. This was like the mushy move that we used to see. The TP, the dagger across to get this observer ward placed. And usually he goes... Usually Mushi would go and like sit up here to try and contest top bounty rune with Dire Spectre. But it looks like Net wants to join the rest of his team further towards the south. While Ohio got obs ward down to the jungle. What does this obs ward give you that one further over to, like, the east doesn't? Is that mainly watching the Doom, I guess?
Yeah. It's harder to get dewarded too.
That's true. Because, I mean, a lot of people have been utilizing the ward up on top of the single unit ramp, and that gets dewarded a lot. Wards down here get dewarded a lot. Yeah.
I think that one's just, we want this ward to stay up here, kind of thing.
Five-man camping up on top of this cliff top, though, with the Mongols. Sentry ward over into medium camp. Maybe they're expecting the Night Stalker to actually build into an Iron Talon level 1, but DJ's got boots first. Kind of indicative of him wanting to run around a little bit more and play aggressively into these lanes, maybe.
DJ is not a passive player. All the heroes that he plays, you just want to run at people. His team definitely complements him, though.
Venge stun, Void from Nightstalker, Sunstrike through.
They have easy Roshan opportunities. They have teamfight setups for the Spectre, which are... That's a really important concept, actually. The teamfight setup for the Spectre. So if something bad happens to Spec, you always have, like... Or if something is weird happening around the map, you can always, like, set up... With, like, the Bat Lasso into the Spec Haunt, you've got, like, an easy way for him to come into the fights without him having to, like, guess.
Oh, you secure one or two targets for him to just jump
exactly.
onto.
A lot of what I'll depend on in this game is, can the Earth Spirit have as much impact as he did last game?
Well, this time around, he's going to be dealing with an Invoker. He does have a Phantom Lancer on his team for this mid lane as well, but... Iron Bolar, Disruptor this time around, as Sanke plays the Outworld Devourer, double Fairy Fire, going to go for the safe lane. Lots of regen build, actually. Maybe a little bit worried about both Bat and Nightstalker being down on that bot lane, while Peace Happiness will be the offlane Doom. All on his own. I do wonder, though, if R70 wants to try and maybe bully the support up at top. Because it's going to be, what, Spectre Venge? It's not the strongest of dual lanes. Venge with a short range, magic missile's okay, but Spectre doesn't really offer you too much in the initial stages. If you have two relatively tanky melee heroes that have some good mobility, and honestly a fair amount of right-click damage, they just need like an Orb of Venom, which Earth Spirit's actually saving up for. I could run the Vengeful Spirit down quite often. But over on Fnatic, DJ Nightstalker, mid 1 Invoker, 3-4-3 Venge. Ohio on that offlane Batrider, and there's... How many heroes? Two heroes with boots level 1. That movement speed advantage can't be understated.
Thanks.
It's equally an option for them to actually run down onto this Disruptor, who's very squishy early on.
Disruptor is a hero too. You want to be ahead with this hero. Like, this hero does not do nearly as much from behind. Everybody kind of knows that. Like, defensive Disruptor kind of gets rid of the point of glimpse. Glimpse is a chasing ability inherently.
And you can't make people run if you're the ones on the back foot.
That's a cute name. Peace Happiness. Dot
Peace Happiness.
Art.
Where is he? Up at top. 343. Not sure what he's doing. Faking out that he's planting a ward or something like that. That's going to be a Satyr at level 1 for the Doombringer. Well, down at bottom lane, Sticky Napalm already being thrown out by Ohio. Just trying to make sure that this OD Sankid doesn't get off to a good start. One last hit is all he has to his name. The Doombringer's just actually farming through the jungle. Not going anywhere near that lane up at top.
Yeah.
Earthspirit's actually aiming towards maybe a roll in onto mid.
It's really easy to kill with Retribution. We talked about it too, right? How the PL's good against the Invoker mid. You can dodge almost all of his spells with the Doppelganger.
With a Doppelganger, do you dispel the minus armor debuff from Force Spritz? Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, oh, 70 misses boy. The roll, but mid one going to try and heal himself up through with the Kwass. I'm not sure this is going to be enough, though. Oh, with a salve, it definitely will. And R70 doesn't have
out,
any way to
should have been a kill,
up
though.
To him. Cancel out the last remnants of the salve, but it's bottom lane where they're diving in a little bit deeper. Ohio, Sticky Napalm with a Firefly down onto the Disruptor, as well as the OD. He'll bail himself away. The fight continues over towards mid, though, as R70 cold snapped and Force Sprit, minus armor, stacking up. He doesn't have a roll for 5 seconds time, but again, there's nothing to chase him down apart from this little summon from the Invoker. He'll have to, like, deny himself to Ancients or something, though, as he rolls on into them. That will be his plan.
This guy owns. He's just dodging everything. Mid one didn't have the Sunstrike available, or he would have gone for it. Re-invokes now into it.
And Earth Spirit insta-TP's back towards mid. He's got roll again.
Yeah, he should go for it. He should have theoretically been able to kill him the first time around. But he missed. He did get a lot of space creation time for his Phantom Lancer, though, who is almost level 4 now.
And level 2 Kwass for mid one. Not going for the 2 points in Exort, realizing he needs more HP regen. Up against all this harassment coming out. But Earth Spirit will make the little wander up towards top lane. And maybe look for the Vengeful.
I think the attack range and duration are better than the damage that you get.
Oh, misses another roll. Net. Gonna praise his lucky stars that he gets away from this. Everyone just keeps popping out these Forge Spirits. How's the bottom lane going, though? OD has actually managed to finally get himself into a nice rhythm of last hits there. 14-1, no longer being fully bullied by the DJ Nightstalker. But Ohio's got himself close to level 4, and it kind of goes both ways, right? You know, the OD has got himself back into this lane, but also the negative side of things is they haven't been able to force either of these heroes away from the lane.
I'm going to send this guy, like, a really strongly worded message. If he doesn't get a wand.
Who, the OD?
The Batrider. Yeah.
Well, he didn't against... Oh, wait, that was a different
that
game.
That was a different game, that but that also was like... come on, man.
Against the Zeus.
This is what that item was built for. There's no reason not to, especially against Batrider. Because he doesn't have burst damage. Like, you get chased down, so you could get a bunch of wand charges off. Very hard to kill.
Oh, no! Oh, 70! Again! Tried to roll across onto mid one, expecting a more aggressive play, but it's just diving mid, diving bot, Sticky Napalm charges, stacking up, Aaron Ball, this Disruptor. He's being chased down behind the trees. He does have a stick, but it will not be enough to save him. Thunderstrike at Ohio.
Doesn't have a lot of mana.
Continue going in for that kill. DJ bottles through. Ohio will save him and help him with that one. As well as the Bounty Rune he'll pick up down at bottom lane. But Earth Spirit, you know, you said that he kind of looks for the early game pressure that he found in game number one. He's not been able to. He's missed 3 or 4 rolls out of the 5 he's attempted. It hasn't been on point.
That first one should have led to a kill. If they're able to land that first one, it's guaranteed kill. He gained PL a huge advantage. Now he's not really sure what to do.
They move the Disruptor in here as well and smoke up together. DD Rune's going to wear off in 5 or 6 seconds. But just look at mid one's positioning. Blocking up the creep wave, making sure Equilibrium is back up, at least closer to his own ramp. He's not going to be able to get it. The range creep is actually holding this one out, so a little bit further forward than he would like, and now with the Lance forward, they've got the Thunderstrike, and mid one will drop. Slowly but surely, even with the Fairy Fires, there's no escape from the 3-man gank there.
Yeah, they really needed that one to work out. It's been a little bit long. The Night Stalker came down initially to this mid lane, try to help out, but he's gonna just make his way down here again as Ohio is bullying this ODL quite hard. Ohio's got 20 CS. More importantly, he's got level 5. OD is only level 4. They're gonna really pressure this safe lane now too. Just gonna force the Disruptor to come down, but Disruptor's gotta be careful. They're just gonna go on him, I think.
Yeah, Fnatic Field in the Astral, but in comes the Haunt, and this is the movement here from Fnatic. Actually gonna jump himself away. His net doesn't want to stick around in bottom lane, but they've got the damage and the kill onto the OD with a kick forward. R70, he doesn't have a roll away. They're gonna get two kills out of this and maybe look for the third as this Disruptor.
I think they can
he's in a ton of trouble. Ohio bottles up after jigging himself back, and now fourth. Sticking A-bomb charges keep stacking up. And Arrow and Ball are three heroes dead on this safe lane. Safe lane
yeah.
from the Mongols.
The cool thing about that too is that Net got glimpsed back and he didn't expect it. He's like, oh, okay.
I thought he jumped back with his Haunt to get himself out there.
No, he got glimpsed. It was nice. It actually ended up working out. This Doom, though, is bullying him like crazy.
It's one of the upsides here for the Mongols. There's Doom sitting on about 2,000 net worth as this offlaner. But let's just look at the Batrider. Ohio is having a cracking game. 1,600 gold. Doesn't go for the Tranquils. He's got his bottle for sustain. He just wants to go straight into the Blink Dagger. As 343, you do not know the pain that is waiting for you. The roll forward from R70. With that Infernal Blade, even with the Magic Missile back from the Vengeful Spirit, try and deny yourself to neutrals, but R70's there with the Boulder Smash to secure. And mid. Well, mid one. Dived by the Phantom Lancer. All these illusions out. Retribution, cold snapped up mid one, trying to shimmy himself away from this. And for now, it's actually working out. Retribution doesn't have a lance to throw. It's a couple of hits to kill off this Invoker. Now the Duke's back mid one, bottled up by Ohio. They're gonna get Retribution's Phantom Lancer. The illusions aren't enough. And Phantom Lancer, dear lord,
oh, he misses the roll again.
R70.
R70.
Deary me.
He's dead. There's the Sunstrike. That was the worst turnaround possible for Mongols. Oh. You've got to be so sad if you're R70. At least kill the Invoker. That's the bare minimum that he wanted there. That dive was so good by that PL2. He just got juked out a little bit.
At this point, it's gone past Failfish, and it's turning into Bible Thump. I'm feeling almost physical pain here for the Earth Spirit. Empathy levels rising. R70. It's such a great game, number one. I don't know what's happened to him in this one, but of course, he still has room to pick things up and maybe try and reset as they do move three or four heroes down towards bottom lane. It does coincide, though, very nicely with Ohio's Blink Dagger pickup. Daytime has arrived and Night
Stalker. You should know everybody's here. I think you should just back.
He's pinging out to go aggressively in with the Haunt. Astral's back onto Chrissy, Night Stalker in the back, and Ohio Firefly over the top of them, but the Doom is down, and this is going to be the Batrider dropping before he even gets the kill. Forward onto the Disruptor and Earth Spirit. He actually picks up the money there.
That was a lot of heroes, though, that they committed for that one.
And the first Doom of the game. As 343 is Invis and hiding. Oh, he's not hiding for much longer. Sankey moves himself a little bit further back, and I think they want to try and pick off Peace Happiness. They know Scorched Earth is gone. So with the Sunstrike, comboed up very nicely here with a Magic Missile. That Fairy Fire is only going to keep you alive for so long. Maybe with an Astral, keeps him alive a little bit longer. Sankey comes in to save his teammate.
There's no he did the smart thing. Eclipse, he hit DJ. Though. But DJ just wands up.
Find the kill. Oh, the roll will land. Missed out on the boulder smash.
Zero
though.
Mana. All right.
Oh, dear. Doom for the Night Stalker. Still okay for Fnatic.
Oh, if 343 could get out. They know he's in there?
Oh, they don't.
Oh, he's just in his hidey hole.
Oh. Night Stalker Midas.
He's already got it, too. 9 minutes. It's pretty quick.
I was kind of wondering whether he goes for, like, phase boots, urn, drums, something.
Oh, they found
that.
Him. Nice. Oh, they did know. I was like, there's no way.
There's no other option for 343. Give the kill over to the OD as well. Now he's got himself... no. He buys his treads over at base. You've got a side shot for that. Come on. 5-8, 9.5 minutes in. Mid lane. I'm going to shove in onto this tier one. While, of course, Spectre, Net, has been left alone for the past minute and a half or so while they grouped up as four down at bottom.
Oh, now he wants to buy a wand.
With OD, yep.
Yeah.
Laning phase is nearly done.
Really feel like that item would have helped out.
Buys the one now. Lasso is still here for Ohio. Firefly as well. It's waiting for someone to pop up and show their face towards mid. It might be the Doom up at top as the bounty rune gets taken. Ohio will know that someone was there. That's the glyph actually thrown out. This is kind of a weird spread of heroes, you know? Mongols, they move OD towards mid, Earth Spirits here as well, disrupt... Bot lane, there's nobody. And it's good realization there from DJ. Chrissy, instead of sitting and farming bottom, you know, he's got the Midas. He's gonna get some kind of gold income regardless, he just has to be active a little bit more. With this Nightstalker is the lasso. Let's catch the Doombringer, but in comes R70 with the Doom back. They're gonna try and eclipse down Ohio. He's dropping and he will die. Eventually, but... Doombringer loses his life in exchange for that one as Chrissy, he's come in to clear up. There's the Magnetize out as R70 does kick across both of them. And this Earth Spirit's keeping himself alive a little bit longer than maybe anyone else expected with a roll further south. R70 doesn't have a little stone though. He's going to get Astral through. And Chrissy with 3-3, they're retreating. The Glimpse though catches the Vengeful Spirit. A Haunt back into things will clear up the Earth Spirit in the back end. They're not going to find anything further forward as this Sunstrike will barely clip the rear of Sanke. But 2-2. Fnatic against Mongols really skirmishing up on top lane.
Still feel like things overall benefit Fnatic just because it's their cores getting the gold. And more importantly, their Invoker Midas, he favors this passive game where he can just set up for Sunstrikes around the map. Like here and there. He's going to get gone on mid though.
Infernal Blade slows him down and the blast is there. Oh, mid one.
Oh! He's dead!
He burnt through in the fountain. He's been pinged out by the Nightstalker. Like, dude, you actually completed your TP. You died to Infernal Blade back in the fountain.
He's probably more upset that Midwan got caught there. It is going to give some space up to this Ventral Spirit, though, who's incredibly underleveled.
You need that swap. I mean, if they had swap there, you know, Midwan gets brought back to the tier 1. Maybe TP's out a little bit further away. Things could have been a bit nicer for him.
This Batrider, though, has had an absolutely absurd game. He's got the highest net worth in the game right now. They were able to contest so much in that bottom lane. I thought OD Disruptor would be pretty strong, especially OD. That's what he's known for, laning, but Batrider really, really made it difficult for him.
It was kind of like the Nightstalker had the 1v1 against Disruptor, and then Bat had a 1v1 against OD. And it was just awkward all around. Oh, okay, Static Storm doesn't kill off 343, and now the Chrissy's here. Doesn't cancel the boulder roll forward, but R70's still going to drop himself here next to the tier 1 tower as the jump forward, Ohio. Sticky napalm, but Lasso is not going to get in range. Disruptor gets himself just far enough out. But Ohio won't be able to catch him.
Still, it's a dead Earth Spirit. You've created more space around the map. Right now, the OD does not have anywhere to really farm. Mid one feels really comfortable pushing this one out at bottom.
And Retribution has to TP top to try and stop Net from farming, but Net's movement back into the jungle. Realizing that if anyone else TP's top, he is definitely open and susceptible to dying. While Ohio is over in the Radiant jungle. Fnatic, you know, Roshan, you said, is a pretty good go for them. Is there a specific moment or point in the game where you're like, let's go do Rosh, guys? Is it a pick-off? Is it like a tier 1 mid falling?
It's probably just you get some control with the Batrider. You don't have to do it right now. It's still a little bit riskier than necessary, just because Earth Spirit plus Disruptor is still really hard to fight into.
Well, smoke up from the Mongols. Move themselves up to top. They're hunting for Net, but again, just look at Net's positioning. He's actually cut himself through into these trees, Quelling Blade across, hiding back in the tree line and making sure he cannot get caught. Because vision here from Mongols, it's kind of lacking. You know, they don't have a Beastmaster. There's no Haunts or Firefly from a Batrider that Fnatic do actually have here, and Observer Ward deep behind tier 1. They're actually pinging this out, saying Net must be somewhere close and somewhere hiding in these trees, but they just don't know where. And it's too much.
Far.
Yeah, he's all the way back behind the tier 2.
They're going to lose a mid tower for this. That's a pretty bad trade.
Oh.
You can go for Roshan too, because the bottom wave is pushed in. I think they just run to Rosh.
Net comes across a stack, not really going to be the easiest for him to take, but in the meantime, you know, Ohio's farming Radiant Jungle, they take tier 1, they go into the Rosh Pit. All of this value is gained by Fnatic. Oh, the Mongols, I think they realize what they've put themselves into here, the situation that they've kind of created for themselves by smoking up towards top, and they're going to contest this Rosh Pit. They've got all their ultimates available, Static Storm with the Earth Spirit on top of it. Of course, pretty good choke point fighting. DJ might be the one to scout out the Earth Spirit movement across. In fact, it's going to be Ohio. He's speedy, he's hasted, he's got the Earth Spirit, and with the nuke damage down, he gets magnetized out, but it's still the continuation of the fight. Net has joined in with a haunt forward, and even with his Sankei OD, he cannot output enough damage. The rest of the Mongols, they're on full retreat. It's, get the hell out of here time. OD is caught with a swap back, and Net, he's deciding not to really battle through this, because that Eclipse is still available from Sankei, and he might decide to turn and throw it, but his damage, oh, look at that. DJ comes through, Ohio gets the triple kill. And Fnatic, back into the rush pit they go.
DJ owned this fight. He was able to silence the Doom. Almost no chance he can turn around and fight. The OD just did not steal enough. And the Batrider actually owns him. Because you want to be able to, with OD, have a lot of movement and fluidity in the fights. But the Batrider made it really difficult for him to engage and re-engage. Oh, man. It's going to be a free Roshan now. And they could not afford that one. That's a rough one. It's going to be a lot of map control lost, and Fnatic are just going to look for fights around the map now as a result.
Blink Force Bat. 16 minutes in. That's an absolute dream for Ohio. It looks like mid one is going to go back for his Yule Scepter. This is more of the kind of standard build we see from him. Sometimes it's the BOT, sometimes it's the Blink, but 9 times out of 10, it's the Yule Scepter after the Brown Boots Midas. Mongols, though, again with a smoke forward. DJ. He is 3-1 and 10, and he's a reasonably good kill here for them. Picking off this Midas holding Nightstalker. What kind of swing is that? What are we looking at here?
It's pretty decent, actually. Yes. He had a lot of gold.
900 swing? He lost 300 of it there, did Chrissy.
More importantly than that, they get map control for free. Like, they were able to do a move that didn't involve them running into the Aegis. Take a free mid-tier 1 tower. Looks like they want to keep going, too. That might be a little bit greedy.
Fnatic don't seem too keen on stopping this. They've got a Haunt and Lasso back up. But no TP towards the tier 2 mid. Glyph will keep it alive.
They needed to make this move sooner. Like, the Batrider has to be there. He's their setup for this.
Tier 2 is only on half HP though, and with this TP coming forward from Chrissy, he's alive again. 3-4-3, he's lining up for this swap onto someone. And with the Haunt, they've Blink Lassoed onto Sankei. They're trying to drop everything down onto them, but the Static Storm, it whiffs completely. It's not landing onto anybody. Ohio's in a 1v1 against the OD, but it's Invoker on the back end. It gets a double kill. Doomed up now, but DJ will focus down onto the Outworld Devourer. The rest of the fight on the back end. Oh, I don't know what's going on back there, but it's the OD that gets dropped behind Tier 2. Phantom Lancer, the last man standing.
That was super greedy for them to take that Tier 1 fight. They knew with the Night Stalker lining up, the Batrider ultimate, that was going to be rough for them no matter what. And even then, the Invoker still has the Aegis, like, going for the Doom on him. You had to still win the fight during that Doom timing, because otherwise mid one would have just lived, came back in and done Invoker things. I'm not sure. Mongols, maybe they feel desperate, like they have to do something here.
Well, they've got that Doom with his Vlad's Buckler, Tranquil Boots, lots of armor and lots of utility behind him. But Phantom Lancer still needs this Diffusal Blade before he can fight. You know, BOT is allowing you to jump around the map, control these lanes, and just farm efficiently, basically. Not getting caught with that Doppelganger available. But getting into that damage item still seems to be the weak link here for the Mongols, as OD is in a similar kind of story. 3-3-5 is his score. Drums, treads, there's no Rod of Atos, no Blink, and we're reaching 20 minutes in as Doom is getting pummeled up on top. Bloody hell.
DJ should be his Ags really soon now, too. Once they take this tier 1 tower top. Oh yeah, and he's right. Ohio's going for it.
Disruptor. In a spot of bother. It's a good boulder smash back from R70, but with the Cold Snap and Firefly. Really no retreat there from Disruptor. Retribution looks like he wants to try and fight through this, but with the Ice Wall down, R70 throws out his Magnetize. Mid one still controls through and gets a nice double kill. Continues his streak to a mega kill one. You just see the Phantom Lancer is like, sod it. Guys, I cannot get involved. He has to go back down towards bottom lane and continue farming.
Nobody can get involved in this game. Like, none of the cores on a show is the thing. Fnatic are just kind of making these moves. Mongols isn't really responding. They seem a lot more listless in this game, too.
Like, Disruptor's job here, it kind of feels that he needs to be the one that glimpses the Batrider when someone gets lassoed.
Yeah, he hasn't been able to.
It's been rough. So there's no one else as a saving support. You know, there's no... Of course, like Dazzle and people like that aren't really used anymore, but there's no Tusk, there's no Venge for them. There's no one to keep any of their cores alive through it.
DJ so farmed.
Holy
that
crap.
That Ag Scepter plus the Batrider.
And the gem.
Yeah.
He's already got a gem as well. It's Ohio's gem, I guess, but...
Yeah.
Regardless. Ohio, even with tranquil boots. He's going to go and buy some boots of travel. Doesn't want tranquils anymore. Wants to get himself around the map, and with a smoke here, probably going to group up with 343 as well as Chrissy. Maybe go and hide yourself in the trees. The rest of the Mongols, they're scared to go top, scared to go towards mid, and they know that there are multiple heroes here in their own jungle from Fnatic, so they're scared to go over there as well. Farming is difficult. Retribution, having his Diffusal Blade at this point, though, might be the saving grace, except he's been spotted. DJ with the Aghanim's upgrade, they just need a Firefly blink and the Haunt perfectly timed there into Retribution. They just got to rip him apart, the Silence down, so he cannot doppelganger forward. Net's caught in the Static Storm, and with the Doom down into the Spectre as well, does he really care about this? The swap back from 343 will save up the Spectre, and the Yules onto Sanke will mean the Ice Wall traps him in place. Even with the Sandy's Eclipse, 343 refuses to die. Fnatic, all of them, refuse to die. Four staff forward, mid one DJ chasing into tier threes.
Okay, this
and
is
the
just
Mongols. This is out of
brutal.
Hand.
Yeah, they're going to lose. Four heroes here. Their Doom is the only one to survive. They have to know that when it comes to late game, they're still a Spectre. And this Nightstalker plus Batrider combination is giving too much vision on the map. There's just too many things that Mongols have to worry about. I don't think this game is really doable at this rate anymore.
And what Spectre sitting on? 3k? 2600? Yeah, not far off. You still consider the Radiance?
Still think Mantis sign here. If he goes Radiant, so the game is over. That's a game ender. That's kind of just the, okay.
I'm a Spectre.
Disruptor's not going to live.
Yeah. It's been really good timing, though, for Fnatic. Every time they haunt, it's been at the exact time the Batrider blinks in. You know, there's no deviation from it. There's no split second haunt before blink lasso before haunt. It's just like, bam, we're in. Let's kill someone.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Efficiency. Dropping all his stat items to get the full value out of the bottle of Ohio as he fills it back up with a nice little bounty rune. Mid one. Doesn't have the Aegis anymore, but he does have an Aghanim Scepter completed on its way out to him. 13,000 net worth on his Invoker, man. 22 minutes in. It's a 15k net worth lead for Fnatic and a 20k experience lead for them. While Doombringer's running around with a Mango. I guess he's a little bit worried. Well, the Mango is not going
to
save you from a Blink Lasso from a Batrider.
Ohio's just kind of made this game his.
He's 11-2-11. He's godlike. Yeah. He's beyond godlike, pretty much.
He's sort of just opened up all the opportunities for his team. His bottom push is going to be nearly impossible for Mongols to stop if they want to go for it. Ohio's got Lasso again in 50 seconds.
And Phantom Lance is farming Ancients. Odie is farming the little Kobolds. Little Kobolds got nothing doing. Buyback from the Doom as Earthsprint's already shredded by the Spectre. And this Disruptor, not going to live too long either. A good glimpse back, though. 343 is caught in the enemy base. Tornado going to clip across the two of them. And this little Vendor's still dead, though.
The Doom alive fight just resets. 4k gold onto net. You've got Aether Lens almost completed on Ohio as well.
Oh, is that what he's going for? Nice.
Yeah, it's pretty common nowadays.
Increase your range, increase your magic damage from Firefly as well. He's got it done. Vengeful Spirits, looking for that item as well. Still needs the recipe though. Invisibility. Well, DJ, 2,000 in the bank on top of Ags and Midas. He's just looking for a creep. He just wants to Midas something. Give me the Wild Wing. Get me to level 16. It's getting a little bit closer to that level 3 ulti. I guess he could think about like Boots of Travel himself if he really wants to. And there's your first item. There is your primary item on OD 24 minutes in, and it's a Rod of Atos.
That is definitely a side item. Like, you want that item
on top of BKB, on top of Blink, or anything.
And they've almost got the Radiance now on net after he finishes one more camp.
Expenditure here is huge onto Ohio. The Glimpse back will stop the TP and they'll secure the kill. Unstoppable streak again goes to the Earth Spirit. Maybe not the best hero to give it to, but at least it lets him finish his Veil of Discord.
Yeah.
Good high ground defensive item there.
They gotta do whatever they can right now in terms of kills. Can't be picky if you're Mongols.
A kill is a kill. There's a kill is a kill. Net. Radiance recipe in his inventory. He can sell his Quelling Blade if he wants to.
He's waiting for the spawn camp.
Oh, right.
He knows, like, even if it, once he buys the Radiance, you don't really need a TP on Spectre. It's all good.
Oh, there we have it.
Radiance.
It's time to be disgusting, Nat. Just pop your ulti right now. Just do it. Just kill the disruptor straight up. Oh, actually, they're smoked, so they wouldn't be able to. Is this somewhat last at Jeffet from the Mongols? They are making a very nice move through their own jungle, though, something that we saw the team previously, Next Generation, struggle with. They're looking for the split pushing Invoker, and the roll forward is almost perfect from R7T. Oh, that blink away, he just bought it! Midrun buys blink, gets out of range, and freaking escapes from that angry movement in from the Mongols.
R7T guessed wrong too on his rock kick. This guy's really good, I can tell, but he's had a rough game. Everything just feels like he's off by like half a centimeter.
Like, that roll estimation was almost perfect. He was, like, 20 range off, catching the Invoker. And then the Invoker just dies. Mid one, he's still going to get defused up. Ghost Walk is there, and there's no reveal back. So DJ looking for the silence. But Retribution, oh, Ice Wall with the Haunt forward. And this Phantom Lancer in a ton of trouble. Sunstrike will land on his head, and he's gone. He's dead. Ohio turns back onto R70. This Earth Spirit pops the Magnetize onto just the Batrider. And it's Fnatic clearing up one after the other. Again, the Mongols lose three without anything in exchange. The OD and the Doom, they're back in the base pretty much. But Fnatic have got free reign to run through the jungle and run down towards bottom tier three.
I think we're getting close to the point where Mongols is going to call it. They've lost so many fights in a row. They could wait for the next Roshan if you're Fnatic, but I don't even think Fnatic cares. This is just like a pick-me-up Roshan. To use it so that it one can't die in the next engagement, but I don't even think it matters too much as he's gonna make his move top.
Astral.
Asanka doesn't have anything else. They might actually catch mid one here. Oh no. Just does that move.
That's like what we were talking about before, he's got like five escape mechanisms. Ghost walks away. But he forced rotation in from two supports and he's got perfect vision of them as well. The Star Observer Ward gives all of that vision down towards the tier 2. And Roshan is secured and picked up by Net. And Spectre. Where are you going? Continues farming. I mean, there's still tier 2s. Oh, hang on a second. Glimpse into Blink, mid one. No Static Storm thrown there by the Disruptor, but he does throw Tornado EMP, looking now for the Cold Snap onto the Disruptor. He can actually try and turn back an ulti, but it's Ohio, the Yule Scepter, gonna catch out. Oh, this OD is in a ton of trouble. Midrun can turn back and just right-click him down. A couple with the Deafening Glass as well. Silence is there, but it's the godlike Invoker that's just ripping the Mongols to shreds. A Static Storm doesn't do anything. R70. Another casualty. With no buybacks on any of them. Phantom Lancer? Oh. He's hungry. He's looking. He's actually killing mid one. Doesn't have mana to yourself himself into the air. And this is going to be a kill from Retribution here. A Beyond Godlike Streak is picked up.
That's a lot of gold.
Oh, 2k gold.
Surprised that Net didn't go into that. Maybe he could have helped them out. Fnatic are just kind of splitting up now. Doesn't really feel like they mind too much. He's going to take out this bottom tower. In the meanwhile, 3-4-3, just getting ward vision out for his team, doing a pretty good job of that so far. Both the games in this series and the Batrider. Gonna start making his way down as he knows that the Invoker has the boots to travel. He can pop in when he needs to. And the Night Stalker kind of stagnated in farm. I can see his 4,000 gold, though. Could go for a Vlad's for his team to help out the push if he wants.
Is it still
That's a full heart for that PL, by the way.
Yeah.
Off the back of that Invoker kill.
Is it still spooky to try and push high ground bot? Like, would you prefer they push tier 2 top lane or something? A little more open?
I kind of want them to just go for it, honestly. I think they're in such a good spot. They take, like, one fight in the game, sort of just ends.
Oh. OD.
Maybe they wait for, like, an AC on DJ if they're super greedy.
OD's up at top. He's not alone, though. To try and clear through the Phantom Lance illusions mid, as well as maybe the real hero is Retribution. It's walked up towards the ancients. Oh, I think Ohio caught a glimpse of him. He did indeed. Oh, he doesn't know which one's the real one. He's going to pop the doppelganger and force away Ohio there. Tornado forward. And now they know. Retribution gets swapped back into the SARS and into the EMP as well. This Phantom Lance is in a ton of trouble. He found the entirety of Fnatic, but he doesn't have any buyback here. 1 minute without your PL. And this could seal the end of the game for the Mongols and the end of their run through the SEA qualifiers.
Oh, this move at top, though. Are they going to go for it onto R70? I don't think this is worth it to commit your entire team back.
They've got the Haunt still from Net, so Net can just...
Yeah. Middle tower is under attack. I think they keep going, though. Test the PL buyback if he has it or not.
That's true. Fnatic don't exactly know. He's nowhere close to it from our bird's eye view. He's 600 gold away from buyback, but it's going to be the bot racks that they've got their eyes on. Forge Spirit still on cooldown, so Alacrity going to be the port of call there for mid one, just to try and take down the melee swap. On to Peace Happiness, and just look at the damage output. He's gone immediately. EMP burnt through. Damage output's good, and with the Tornado forward, they're going to take out another couple of supports as well. The Earth Spirit's gone with the Disruptor, and Sankey, the OD, is the last man standing. Racks are taken out, and GG is called before a single freaking building falls. Mongols, good luck further to Fnatic, as Fnatic against Warriors Gaming Unity will be our grand final tomorrow in a best of five. But we've seen some good upsets, some good underdog stories here from the SEA qualifiers. The Vietnamese team, Next Generation, Mongols Gaming, there's been some pretty good SEA teams popping up.
Yep, I think Warriors is going to give a pretty good fight too. I think Mongols could have won that first game, and I think after that one, it just kind of like, you get on tilt. Because that was a team that they're not supposed to beat. But they got really close to it, and I think they're going to feel bad about that one.
Well, that's it for today, guys. Thanks for joining us. We will be back tomorrow, 12 midday CEST, which is, oh dear me, 6 p.m. Singapore time. You're 6 hours ahead now, not 7. So 6 p.m. Singapore time tomorrow for the ESL Southeast Asian Qualifiers Grand Final. Best of five, Warriors Gaming Unity up against Fnatic, the Malaysians against the Malaysians. Blitz and myself will be covering that one again. But for now, goodbye. Have a good evening. Have a good day, and see you guys tomorrow.